The Minister of State for Finance, Henry Musasizi, together with the State Minister for Microfinance, Haruna Cheyune, appeared before the Parliamentary Committee of Finance to justify proposed amendments in the Microfinance Deposit-Taking Institutions Amendment Bill of 2022. The amendments seek to rename microfinance institutions as banks, which the government believes will help to create an impression of confidence in the target audience of the microfinance sector.
Even where we are coming from, they look at these institutions as circles. They look at these microfinance deposit-taking institutions as circles. So the perception is that, you know, because it lacks that word bank, in fact, these institutions are losing customers.
However, committee members oppose the proposal, saying it is going to ignite confusion in the banking sector.
And the most important thing here also is we are not only talking about these institutions. A moment you become a public, you begin a recipient of public funds in terms of deposit taking, the level of regulation must go up.
Some legislators raised a lot of questions on the motive of the bill, expressing concerns that the proposed reforms don't conform to the international standards. The MPs are not convinced that MDIs have anti-money laundering requirements.
People be able to, for example, these banks, they must now adopt IFRS standards in terms of their financial reporting. They must now adopt Basel 1 and Basel 2 in their compliance and risk and operational management and market risks. And the question I ask is, are they ready where the central bank sits?
But Kasolo labored to convince the committee that microfinance institutions have been losing customers to commercial banks because Ugandans put a lot of confidence in the World Bank. Notably, the bill seeks to provide for bank assurance and agent banking services to microfinance institutions, which have been a monopoly of commercial banks. Government believes this will enhance financial inclusion.
The minister undertook a regulatory impact assessment because I feel this should shed more light beyond this bill about this program.
Government also seeks to roll out Islamic banking in microfinance deposit-taking institutions, MDIs, which have been a preserve of the commercial banks. Story by Fred Kajubi for the news.